Welcome back, guys, to another PvE build for the Waking Flame DLC. Back to my Stamina Dragon Knight. Like in the previous patch, I used a 2H dual setup, but this time I dropped Consuming Trap, this one, and Rending Slashes for Carve. They've changed the skill here. The bleed damage can stack now up to 3 times and it's really powerful. It did 8 to 9k DPS in total, I think even more than Stampede. After 1 hour parsing, I managed to get 106k DPS, which is pretty decent as a Stamina Dragonite. Build wise, nothing has really changed. Still 7 medium with the Harpooner's Waiting Kill, the Smithic item, Reliquen, Advanced Nukeda, Slime Core, and the Black Ghost Prison Daggers on the back bar. The rotation is quite different now, since I use Carve as an Exodot. I will explain the rotation first, then I'll show you the pass, and afterwards the build showcase. Let's go. The rotation is quite simple. Use Flames of Oblivion and Deadly Cloak as pre-buff. Step closer to the target, use Barb Trap and Noxious Breath. Use Carve once, Venomous Claw and Stampede. Use Carve again, but twice in a row to gain those 3 bleed damage stacks. Go back to your back bar, use Standard of Might, your ultimate, to empower all of your abilities. Use Wrecking Blow as spammable in between. If one dot expires, reapply it again. Try to make sure that you keep all your Carve stacks until the end. I normally use it every 8 to 9 seconds, so I make sure that I don't lose those stacks. Keep this rotation up until 31%, then drop Wrecking Blow for execution as spammable, and drop Noxious Breath completely, otherwise it's a DPS loss. But keep all the other dots up, even Carve all those 3 stacks until the end, and that's it. Pretty simple. If you have questions about it, type it in the comment section below. I will try to answer them, like always. Now enjoy the pass. Let's take a look on the build. 5 Reliquin on the body. 1 Slime Core for extra crit rate. 1 Harpooner's Wading Kilt. If you don't have access to mythic items, you can go with 1 Slime Core and 1 Gundwolf. Then advancing Yokida on the front bar with a Maul for extra penetration. In raids, I recommend to use the Raid Sword or the Great Axe. Back bar, still the same, Black Ghost Prison daggers. If you don't have access to Black Ghost Prison, you could go still with the Maelstrom Arena Bow. Alternative, instead of Reliquin for dynamic boss fights, for example in Asylum or Cloudrest, where the bosses are porting around, you could go with Yandir here instead. And instead of Yokida, you can also use Kinoas here. Traits, full Divines on the body, full Bloodthirsty on the jewelry, Precise Maul and Double Infused on the back bar. Glyphs, full max stamina here, full weapon damage on the jewelry, double dot poisons on the front bar, and on the back bar a poison and a flame damage enchantment. Skills on the front bar, Executioner or 2H Execute, Carve, a super powerful 2H dot now, Wrecking Blow as spammable, Venomous Claw, Stampede, and Flawless Dawnbreaker. It's kinda sad that we have 4 2H skills on our front bar and only 1 class ability. Well, Zost thinks, right? On the back bar, Camouflage Hunter, that's our flex spot. You can go with Soul Trap, Consuming Trap here instead, if you have sustain issues, or Rending Slashes, also possible. Or in dungeons without a healer, for example, you can put Vigor here instead. Deadly Cloak, Barb Trap, Noxious Breath on the back bar. It's simple, we don't have space on the front bar anymore. That's why I put it on the back bar here. Flames of Oblivion, and Standard of Might, of course, one of the strongest ultimates out there. It gives 15%. More damage. Super powerful. Raise, still Dunmore for extra weapon damage and max stamina. Khajiit is almost similar and Orc is fine too. Asmundus the Thief for extra crit rate. Lava Food Soup as buff food. If you don't have sustain issues in raids, for example, you can still go with the green max stamina food. 64 points in stamina. Potions, always the same, with stamina, brutality, and savagery. CPs, blue ones, Fighting Finesse, Backstabber, Taumaturge, and Master at Arms. If you can't flank the enemy, swap Backstabber for Deadly Aim. Red ones, Boundless Vitality, Fortified, Rejuvenation, and Sustained by Suffering. That's it with another PvE build. Next one will be a Stamina Warden one. Thanks for watching and the support. I wish you all a fantastic summer, and I see you hopefully in the next video. Ciao!